So 1.1.1.1 just introduced Warp and Warp Plus. Is it a streaming service? New ISP? What is it? What's up? I'm Mike, and welcome to BenderTube. We get bite-sized tutorials and tech reviews. Let you know if you get it or forget it. If you're new here, hit the subscribe button and click for notifications so you don't miss out on anything. So for a little background, Cloudflare's 1.1.1.1. We're just going to call it 1. From now on. 1. Is a service that will look up the physical address or IP address of the website you're trying to look up, like google.com or something like that. Except it's going to find that website faster than the one that your internet service provider, like Comcast, provides for you. The other thing is 1. Doesn't record any information from that lookup, unlike your ISP. Now that Cloudflare has released Warp, it takes that 1. Service and adds in some fixes for things like 4G LTE and Wi-Fi that honestly have existed since mobile data became a thing. The internet was designed around a physical connection, a cable plugged into one computer and plugged into a router or another computer. It didn't account for wireless connections. They weren't even a thought when internet protocols were created. So when you're uploading a paper to the school server or downloading a movie and your roommate decides they want to use the microwave to make a Hot Pocket, all of a sudden your paper's corrupted, your movie doesn't want to play because the file's corrupted. So what happened? Why did this happen? Well, when internet protocols, the IP stack, were created, no one was thinking that you were going to be sending out and receiving electromagnetic waves full of information, and no one thought that other electromagnetic waves are going to be hitting those and possibly causing data corruption and packet loss. That's what Warp is trying to fix. From your connection from you to them, they're trying to make sure you don't lose packets, or if you do, they know what they are and they rectify it. Now, just like with 1. Cloudflare is doing this with the creation of a VPN. And anyone that typically uses a VPN knows that it's usually slower than the connection that you're already on. So according to Cloudflare, this was the next hurdle they wanted to get over. They didn't want you to notice if there was any kind of lag or anything in the service review. They want it to be the same experience as if you weren't using it at all. Having used it for a couple weeks, I can honestly say they probably accomplished that goal. I noticed no discernible difference between me using a regular Wi-Fi connection and using Warp. The page loads just as fast. I download stuff just as quickly. There's no problems with it whatsoever for me. I will say I was having some problems with YouTube. I would go to watch a video using Warp and it would take anywhere from 10 seconds to 2 minutes to watch the video. It was just loading. Once it loaded, yeah, everything, full resolution, no buffering problems. But it still took 10 seconds to 2 minutes for it to load, which is weird. Now, I reported the bug. I reported the bug to Cloudflare. They messaged me within a day saying that, yeah, they were aware of the problem. They're going to work on it. Okay, to be honest, like, that's what I expected. You know, everybody says, oh, we're going to work on it. Yeah, okay. A week later, just like last time with 1.1, a week later, they fixed it. On top of that, they went the extra step. They have no clue who I am because they don't have any information on me. They have no clue who I am. They still sent me a message saying, hey, just so you know, that issue you're having with YouTube, we think we fixed it. Why don't you go ahead and try? That is some great customer service for a service I don't even pay for. Now, being VPN, Warp does provide end-to-end encryption for your data, so it's secure. What it doesn't do, though, is hide your IP address or change your geolocation. So if you're in a country where content is locked down, you need to change your location to be able to see like a YouTube video or something that's not available where you live, and your IP address is out there. So if you're trying to download some torrents on the DL, not gonna happen. For anything like that, you are gonna need a different VPN service. And I know Guy Creator Made, he has a bunch of videos on the different VPNs, what they offer. So you should go check him out. I'll leave a link to his channel. If it doesn't do those things, who's this for? Well, it's basically for people who wanna be a little bit more secure on public networks and worry a little less about data loss. Just something simple for the guy sitting at a Starbucks on airport Wi-Fi or just walking around the city. Also, it's free. Now, usually they say when you don't pay for the product, you are the product. But in this case, they don't collect any information about you, what you're doing with it, any of that. They don't even serve up ads, and they don't even collect an email address from you. On top of that, they pay auditors to prove all this. That's not to say they don't have a paid version. The difference between the free version and Warp Plus is that with Warp Plus, you get access to their Argo routing technology. In simple terms, it routes your internet traffic through the least congested networks. Kind of like how if you use Waze, it'll route you around a traffic jam as long as it can. Now, they say it's up to 30% faster, but in my time of testing, I haven't been able to see that difference yet. Warp Plus is available for the cost of a Big Mac near you. I'm serious, they determine how much it costs, not more than $5 though, by how much a Big Mac costs in your area. That's kind of cool, but regardless if you're paying $5 or less, that's gonna get you unlimited data. And if you use the link down below that I have in the description, you actually get 1 gig of Warp Plus for free. Now, what's really cool there is you don't have to put any information at all. You just install the app, you get the free 1 gig of Warp Plus, and when you use it all up, back to regular Warp. They're not gonna charge you, so you don't have to worry about you can get that Mac attack in, and if you wanna add it in later, go right ahead. I know I thought it was gonna be a hassle when you had to switch between VPNs back when this was just one dot, but now I think this is an advantage, assuming they keep working on this and get whatever little bugs are in here worked out. You get basic encryption, security, and a more reliable internet connection for your everyday stuff, walking around. And then if you want more restricted stuff, sensitive stuff, you just switch to your normal VPN server. And if your VPN service has a data cap, or like say you get 100 gigs for free a month or something, and then you have to pay if you want more, this helps alleviate that stress depending on what you're doing, because you don't have to go use it if you're at Starbucks or on the hotel Wi-Fi anymore. So, no, this isn't your typical VPN service. Is this something you still be interested in using? Let me know over on Twitter or down in the comments section below. And in case you're liking the shirt, you could pick one up for yourself. I'll leave links down in the description below to my merch store. And that's it for me today, guys. If you liked the video, found it helpful in any way, leave a like, leave a comment, and as always, I'll see you in the next one.